National Federation of the Blind. Live the life you want through science, technology, engineering, and math. Quick rule introduction with Mark Barlow.
Hello, my name is Mark Barlow. I'm the Industrial Arts Instructor at Blind Incorporated in Minneapolis, Minnesota. This is the click rule. It is a tactile measuring device. What I'd like to do is just start by going over the anatomy of the click rule. And if I'm holding the tube in both hands, in my left hand, at the end of the click rule is what I call the fence. It's a rectangular piece of aluminum, and the fence has a front, and the fence has a back. That's important. From the fence to the hook is what I call the tube. Past the tube is, on the right-hand side, is the hook. It hangs perpendicular to the fence, and that's an important design feature of this tool as well. On top of the tube is the knob, and the knob loosens to the left, tightens to the right. You loosen the knob to the left and slide the knob down the tube, and out comes information. And the information is indexed on a 3/8 inch steel rod that has been turned by the 16th of an inch. On the top of the rod, the maker then grinds off 7 threads and leaves the 8th. Grinds off 7, leaves the 8th, grinds off 7, leaves the 8th, all the way up the information rod. What that does is that gives us a tactile indicator of a half an inch. The click rule is called a click rule because it clicks. So as I currently, my information rod is fully extended to the last half inch indicator. And I say to the last half inch because it's, for some click rules, it's possible to overextend it in kind of a half click kind of way. You can bump in sometimes in between a click or kind of get a little overextension of the information rod. So what I ask my students to do is to think that the end of the information rod is zero. And then as students are learning to count this by the half inch, I ask them to count up the information rod from zero. So it is zero, half, one and a half, oh, sorry, zero, half, one, one and a half, two, two and a half, three, three and a half, all the way up to 6. Now, I know that that is 6 because I can just get my fingernail past the half inch indicator, or that 6-inch indicator, and if I subtract one click, if I click one in from the end of the information rod to the front of the fence, is now 5 15/16. I cannot feel the half inch indicator, which is 6 inches. And of course I know that that is 5 15/16 because I just subtracted 1/16. If I did not know that that distance, which I call a mystery click, so if I did not know the distance between the 5 1/2 inch indicator and the fence, what I would do is I would count this up from zero all the way up to 5 1/2. And then I would capture that. Some students capture it with their pointer finger nail. I tend to double hand the click rule. I have my left hand holding the body of the tube, palm up. My right hand thumbnail captures the 5 1/2 inch indicator. And then what I do is I slowly and carefully click down. I move the fence down into my thumbnail. And I count the clicks as I go. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7/16 is, or 7 clicks. Each click is a 16th of an inch. And so that gives me 7/16 that I need to add to 5 1/2. 5 1/2 is the same as 5 8/16. 8 + 7 = 15. So it is 5 15/16. when I subtract, I support both of my hands. I have the information rod firmly gripped in one hand, and then I slowly click that rod into the tube. And sometimes what I find easiest to add clicks is I literally pinch the information rod out of the fence, and I kind of roll my thumb and my pointer finger in as I'm pinching. I kind of pinch it out one little click at a time.
And that's how blind people do STEM. For more information, visit blindscience.org.